Higher Life in Christ, sponsored by Brother Leo Quadros.
The healing ministry of the man of God, Pastor Chris, has touched the lives of many across the globe, mending broken bodies and restoring hope to the hopeless. Many have had their lives transformed when they come into contact with the awesome power of God that is at work in the healing school. On today's episode, we bring you the inspiring testimony of Kelvin, a 24-year-old man who lived a normal life until 2012, when he started losing balance when walking. This persisted, and he decided to see a doctor. And after several tests and examinations, he was diagnosed with small vessel disease and early mechanical disc degeneration. His condition deteriorated to the point where he could no longer walk and had to use a wheelchair for mobility. Life became miserable for him, as his hopes and dreams were shattered due to his condition. It was in this state that Kelvin came to the healing school. Watch his story.
My name is Kudakwashe Kelvin Maposa. I come from Zimbabwe. I'm 24 years old. The condition that brought me to the healing school is small vessel disease and early mechanical degeneration of disc L4, L5, S1, and L5. The condition started 4 years ago in 2012. Just started with me. When I started walking, I started losing balance. I started feeling some funny sensations in my body, like electricity is moving through all my body. So I went to the doctor and he did some tests, an MRI scan. That's when they found out that the small vessel disease and early mechanical degeneration of discs L4 and L5, S1 and L4. The doctors explained to me that this condition is like this, the part of the brain that is responsible for coordination is dying out. I was on medication, then I stopped because it wasn't working, and physiotherapy. I was doing physiotherapy, but it seemed to be not working. And the doctors said I should increase the medication, the dosage of the medication, after a certain time, because he said after a certain time there should be some improvements with the medication. So I increased the doses of the medication, but there seemed to be no improvement at all. As a result of this condition, I feel back pains, I feel pains in my head, I feel my muscles are weak, I feel my left leg, it's not stepping on the ground firmly. It's not like straight, it feels like I can't straighten, it's bent on the knee here. I had to get the wheelchair for my mobility sake. As a result of this condition, I have stopped going to school. I was supposed to be in school this semester, so I couldn't go to school because of this condition. I can't always stay indoors. I can't go out because of this condition. This condition has affected me emotionally. Sometimes I used to cry because of this condition. I would say to myself, why me? Because of this condition. And a lot of anger when I say, can you do this for me? When the person delays, I would be frustrated. And sometimes I would just emotionally break down, cry for me. Because of this condition, it has affected me a lot. Emotionally.
Kelvin's medical report indicates that early spondylotic changes with intranuclear clefts are noted between the L4, L5 and between the L5, S1 disc levels.
I want God to heal and restore me so that I can get back with my life and be able to do all that I can't do and go back to school and live a normal life again. I believe God will heal me through the man of God, Pastor Chris. That's why I came to the healing school.
Believing in the power of God to cause a total change in his situation, Kelvin came to the healing school. The Bible says in the book of Acts 5 and verse 16, there came also a multitude out of the cities round about unto Jerusalem, bringing sick folks and them which were vexed with unclean spirits, and they were healed, every one. The healing school is a remarkable place where God's loving kindness and grace overflow. It is an oasis of hope for the hopeless and a place of answers to those with burning questions. The arena was supercharged. God's love and his earnest desire to liberate all was evident. Those in line for their miracles were comforted, knowing that this was God's set time for them. A distinct intensity filled the hall. This signaled that the man of God, Pastor Chris, had arrived. All present exalted the name of the Lord more than ever as they saw the living word of God in action. And now the man of God approached Kelvin and glanced at his case card. He laid his hands on his back, correcting every anomaly in his body. The man of God laid his hands on Kelvin's forehead and blew on him. That's the power of God going through Kelvin's body. The man of God declared him free. Wow, Kelvin is up on the street running and rejoicing for his miracle. He is doing all he wasn't able to do before. He is free from every sickness and disease that held him back. What a miracle! Glory to God!
Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome Kelvin Kudakwashi.
Amazing. Kudakwashi. Congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
God has filled your mouth with laughter.
Thank you, sir.
And now you look so young, much younger than the Kudakwashi we saw. That must be the power of God.
Yes, sir.
Congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
How did you find yourself in that state that you were? And what was life like for you? A young guy in that state, on a wheelchair, unable to help himself.
It all started in 2012 with me losing balance when walking. During the period of 2012 to 2016 January, the condition grew worse. I went through several scans, MRI scans, CT scans, several diagnoses from different doctors, different medications from different doctors, physiotherapy, a lot of symptoms always manifested during the period 2012 and 2016 January. The condition grew worse to the point of 2016 January, I couldn't do things for myself. I couldn't bath for myself, I couldn't climb the stairs without assistance. I stopped even going to school. The condition made me to become angry. I was emotionally down, I became emotionally down. I could cry, saying, why me? I got frustrated. Then I was scheduled to go to India for an operation. We were working on me and my mother and my family members were all working on me to go to India.
And how did you now find yourself at the healing school?
A reverend friend told us about the healing school. He was at the minister's conference, so he told my mother you should go with Kuda to the healing school. So my mother came to me and asked me, Kuda, do you want to go to the healing school or to India? Me, I was afraid that the operations at India would be 50-50. So I just said the healing school. I didn't know about it, the healing school, what would take place at the healing school. I just said the healing school.
You need to tell us something. The man of God ministered you. How did you feel? What happened? Tell us your experience.
And the man of God, Pastor Dr. Chris, ministered to me. Before he ministered to me, I started shaking when he was ministering to a lady before seated next to me. I started shaking. When he came on me, he laid hands on my back and he laid his hands on my forehead. And I just stood up. I felt a lot of energy in the rain. I just found myself there.
Since you got healed to this moment, how has it been like for you?
Since I got healed, I can walk faster. I went back to school. Now I'm in campus ministry. Now I can do a lot of things. I can park on my own. I can drive. I can sit on the chair for a long time. I can see you all. I want to thank the Lord for the divine healing and the restoration. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. To the partners of the healing school, I want to say thank you very much. We came here, all the things were free. Thank you very much. To the man of God, Dr. Pastor Chris, I love you, sir. Thank you very much for impacting my life with the word of God and impacting the whole world with the word of God and the healing power of God.
Congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
God bless you.
Thank you, sir.
God
thank
bless you.
Just so enthralled by the testimonies and gripped by those. We heard the live testimonies as they brought people up from past healing services. You could just feel the room grow in excitement and the people, their faith level rising. Especially they had me do one about the guy that was spent in the wheelchair that he come jumped up and ran out and how Pastor Chris had prayed for him. It was just amazing. And to see all those miracles and to hear those testimonies is just an incredible, incredible time. And you just felt the love of God all through this place, and you just knew that Jesus was here. Just his presence was just awesome.
Calvin came to the healing school diagnosed with small vessel disease and early mechanical disc degeneration. His condition deteriorated to the point where he could no longer walk and had to use a wheelchair for mobility. Calvin came to the healing school with faith in his heart for a miracle. At the healing school, the man of God, Pastor Chris, ministered to him, and he was completely free. Today, Calvin testifies of the awesome power of God that transformed his life.
Now I can do a lot of things. I can bat on my own. I can drive. I can sit on the chair for a long time. I can walk faster. I went back to school. Now I'm in campus ministry.
Wow, what a miracle! And just as the Bible says in Luke 1, verse 37, for with God nothing shall be impossible. Calvin is totally free from every sickness and disease that held him bound. His hopes and dreams have been restored back to him. What a miracle! Hallelujah!